Thank you for choosing ProtoWizard. In this tutorial, we will build a head using the head wizard. This will give you a basic idea of what the new ProtoWizard is doing with the models of the parts, since it is something special. Select the file and we'll bring in our head model. Now I want you to notice that it has taken the top of this model and placed it at Z0 in the XY plane. So if you look at it from the top down, it has taken the very top of the model and placed it right at Z0. This will become more self-explanatory in a second. When we select the setup for the head wizard, it's going to ask us what is our basic dimensions of the raw material and how far away from where we're going to end up putting the core file for the top down cuts in the center line of this part. So therefore, what we really want to do is we want to say, okay, our bar diameter is typically either a 21 or 33 millimeter rod diameter, and then the distance from the center line offset to the top of the ring is going to be 25 millimeters to the top of the head. This is so that when it's posted out, it knows to take what it has here and shift it up 25 millimeters in Z for the top down cut and out 25 millimeters in Z for the rotary cut. Now we'll go into our operations. Again, because of the way this part is structured, we now can choose whether we want to see this part positioned horizontally or vertically. So in our particular operations that we're going to do here is we're actually going to lay this part down in the rotary . Select a tool. And tell it that we want to cut this part out in no more than 5 millimeter depths of cut. Now it's showing us the outline of our part. This is so as if it was be sitting in the machine. With what we have here, we can now establish where we really want to make all of our cuts. And it knows that based on the diameter of our part, if it needs to make multiple cuts, it will. So now we can just establish that we definitely want to do from 0 to 360. We're going to cut all the way out here to our part boundary. We have our minimum maximum diameters that we want to utilize. And then we also have the width of the cut that we're going to take here. And we're going to tell it that we do want to use our fast roughing. And we're going to add that operation to program one. Now we're going to be able to use a top-down cut to do the other part of this, and we're going to use this in the vertical position. So by selecting my tool, using this in the vertical position, we'll just call this operation a top-down. I'm now looking at the part like this. Now I don't really need to cut all the way down here to the bottom because this part's already been cut out. And you know, we really don't need to cut anywhere but around the edge of the part. So what I'm going to do is say only cut to the part edge. And I'm also going to go ahead and say I want to bring this this minimum Z value. Well, let's see. Let's take it up to about -5. See where that puts us. Okay. So in other words, it'll drop down through this hole to -5 if we wanted to go that far. If we didn't want it to go that far, we could change this and make it, you know, to whatever we want. But that's fine. So we're going to cut to just to the part edge. We're not going to cut all the way out to this boundary. And we're going to go ahead and cut down through the hole to -5. And we're going to set this as program two. And now we're going to calculate. Okay, now the toolpath is finished calculating. Let's see our toolpath. These are our two passes that are taking the material down to the size that we want it. And notice that because we have the fast roughing turned on, again, our passes are three times what the finished pass will be. Okay. And then we have our top down toolpath. And like I said, the nice thing about this is that now that when you post this out, it'll post out with everything shifted 25 millimeters up, because that's what we set, and you don't have to move it or have to know what you're doing as far as to arrange that. And as always with ProtoWizard, you just go to the Generate tab and create your machine program.